In this video, we're given a waveform for an RC circuit, and we're told the resistance in the circuit is 47.1 ohms. And the big goal here is to determine the capacitance of the capacitor in the circuit by studying the waveform. So when we look at the waveform, we see the classic RC form. I have the capacitor charging fast at first and then leveling off exponentially. And then when the square wave turns off, it discharges fast at first and then leveling off exponentially. This is the end of one period. And with units of milliseconds on the t-axis, I count 12 milliseconds for one period to be complete. In part A, we're asked for the frequency, and that's just the reciprocal of the period, so we'll just get that done real quick. And the 12 milliseconds can be written as 0.012 seconds. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 83.3 hertz. Now, part B is the more important question, and I'm just trying to get the capacitance of the capacitor in this circuit. Well, that's related to the half-life of the charge time or the decay time. And I can see I have these cursors up in the oscilloscope window. And this is actually how a lot of digital oscilloscopes work. You can set these cursors where you want them and it will tell you what the time difference is or what the voltage difference is. I notice the square wave goes from 0 to 6 volts. And what I've done with my vertical cursors is start when the capacitor is fully charged and I'm at 6 volts. And then I go to a vertical value of 3 volts, and that gives me the point where the capacitor is halfway discharged. Then I use these vertical cursors to look at the time where the capacitor was last fully charged and the time where it's half charged, and that is the half-life. And the half-life of an RC circuit is related to the resistance and the capacitance. So I'm going to write down the formula that I remember for this, that the half-life over the time constant tau is equal to natural log 2. And in an RC circuit, tau is equal to the product of resistance and capacitance. So that's RC. So I have half-life over RC equals natural log 2. We solve for C. I'm going to multiply both sides by C and then divide by natural log 2. And I get that C is equal to my half-life divided by R natural log 2. Now my half-life is displayed right there on the oscilloscope. It's 0.555 milliseconds, which we'll write as 0.000555 seconds. And then my resistor measured at 47.1 ohms. And then I have a natural log 2 factor in there. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 1.70 times 10 to the negative 5th farads, and I can change that to 17.0 microfarads. And we actually frequently use this idea as a tool in the lab for measuring very small capacitances. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.